are. You're looking perkier this morning.
Really?
Yeah, definitely got more colour.
Typical.
Well, that's a good thing, isn't it?
No, well, just when I got with a new doctor. And how stressful is that, trying to arrange an appointment around work? Now I know how our patients feel. Till you've walked a mile in someone else's shoes.
Which practice did you go with?
Rose Walk in the end. They were the only one... What?
Oh, just nurse's gossip. Sure it'll be fine.
No, you're right, I am feeling much better. Shoot across the sky. What?
At the class.
Tomorrow, silly. Boom, boom, boom.
The calendar's wrong.
What? No.
But what if it puts people off who really need, you know, antibiotics?
Yeah, but, well, it's just a conversation starter, you know? What's that about, they say? And then you tell them how easy it is to sign up online, you know? Just a few clicks, Mrs. Smith, and then they can have a certificate all of their very own.
But aren't there some conditions that get worse if they're not treated?
Yes. My neighbour Ethel, she suffers terribly with her allergic rhinitis. And her GP wouldn't give her antibiotics, so she ended up buying them online.
Yeah, but you can't even treat allergic rhinitis with antibiotics. And in any case, of course, I would never advocate that... Ah, Mrs. Tenby. It came to me last night.
Well, what did?
I always find my best ideas float to the surface, last thing.
What? Floated to the surface.
Oh, yeah, my idea. Emailing the whole patient database and asking them to become antibiotic guardians.
Emailed the whole...
I got it. Thank you.
Dr. Veer. Dr. Veer, as much as I applaud your commitment...
Crosswords!
I cannot sanction unsolicited emails to all our patients.
But surely in this case...
No one likes to be spammed.
Too much Viagra and PPI.
Yeah, but this isn't strictly...
No. Naturally, we will support you in all your other efforts. And if you need any help, please, just ask.
Thank you, Mrs. Tenby. That'll be really helpful.
You just found the letter.
What letter?
From hospital.
Not enough for the taxi.
Please, Mum, it's really important.
No, I'm about to start work, love.
If not there, we'll get into trouble.
Look, just calm yourself down.
It's a mix-up.
Mel, I don't
want you going off on...
Bus, then.
Two buses, we won't make it.
We'll have to. Come on. Let's get your coat on. There we are.
Oh, the bag!
We'll miss the bus!
They do say that blue is calming.
I was thinking more of a statement colour.
Yeah, but red for danger.
Is it too aggressive?
Well, it's a bit... snappy, perhaps.
Really?
Al?
What?
For the awareness display, is red too aggressive?
Oh, mate, you are wasting your time. No campaign, even if it is a red one, is going to make the slightest dent on the superbugs of the future.
Oh, yeah, but if everyone took that stance...
Sydney, just resign yourself to the fact that this form of the human race is ultimately doomed.
Oh, Dr. Husky.
Yeah, perhaps, yeah. After the blue bit.
Bursting Sid's bubble again?
Yeah, well, just letting a little bit of air out. Having said that, I'm not completely against his awareness dealy.
Oh, not completely.
Well, if it cuts back on the time wasters, then he can put balloons wherever he likes.
Time wasters?
Yes, Valerie. Time wasters. The worried well. Someone comes to see me with a tickly cough, I send them straight to a pharmacist. I've got better things to do.
Harsh. Although some of them do just want to chat. Which isn't actually fair on those who are actually sick.
Exactamundo.
Miss Pittman, now, I know that we agreed that you would have a couple of hours off.
Yes.
But I need these reports typed up before tomorrow.
Well...
excuse me.
Well, there are a lot of distractions today. So, please, if you could postpone your plans.
Of course, Mrs. Tenby. If I'm needed here, I mustn't desert my post.
Thank you, Miss Pittman.
It's a matter of priorities, Mrs. Tenby.
Indeed.
Oh,
gone? Her maid is here.
Please, could you help us by...
If not there...
It'll be all right, Mel.
Hello.
Hello, it's Jason. We didn't forget.
Hello, Jason. Are you all right?
We don't know when's the next bus.
Is Mel with you?
Yes, there's been a mix-up.
We're trying to get to class.
Don't be cross.
Jason, no one's cross with you. Just tell me exactly where you are.
Fountain Road, number 38 bus stop, near the chippy across the road.
Yeah, I know it. Right, I'm going to be about 15 minutes. You stay there.
OK.
She's coming. Thanks, Rumour. Bye.
OK, bye.
We're going to make it.
Amelia. Come in.
Oh, I don't want to disturb.
No, you're not at all. Please, come in.
This won't take long.
Look, come through.
Bump was on the wrong day.
What bump?
On the calendar. But we found the letter.
Getting good with his reading.
Couldn't read the buses.
Oh, no one can read the bus timetables.
No.
You did the right thing by calling me.
Thanks.
Come on.
Right.
I'm sure I've got some biscuits here somewhere. I'm not really on top of the household at the moment. You know when some things just seem so unimportant. Oh,
I can imagine.
Here they are. Oh, and they're even in date.
Oh, please don't bother.
I'm afraid they're only plain.
Not for me, thanks.
Right, Amelia.
Emma,
sorry, I was just going to say I'm really glad that you've reconsidered.
Reconsidered?
Yes, your inheritance.
Oh, no, I haven't changed my mind about that.
Oh.
No, I came to ask... Well, I'm here because I'd like to spend some time in Howard's house.
There will be crying, yes, but there's nothing wrong with that. Your baby is communicating with you. So if you've changed its nappy, fed it, and it is still crying, what you might try and do is... Sorry, Mel.
It might want some cuddling or some jiggling.
Yeah, absolutely.
Could have been in here.
Yeah, that's right. Hiya, Bev. Do you want to just come in?
Sorry.
That's all right.
Excuse me. Careful. There we are. I've been worried sick. I cancelled my shift and all.
Sorry.
Didn't answer your phone, did you?
Are you all right, Bev?
Yes, thank you.
OK, so we've been discussing the first few hours and weeks when a baby arrives home. And now, as promised, we are going to talk about the famous... hospital bag. Please, do not worry about what you pack, OK? If you've got your bags, let's go get them.
The calendar are wrong.
I told you not to mess with it. Well, look, it's worked out because I'm here now.
Great, let's get them open, see what you've got.
Did you remember to pack the nighty I bought you?
Here.
And the slippers?
Sanitary towels. Excellent. You'll need lots of those. Yeah, Lola, sometimes a woman needs big pants. Yeah, personally, I wear my pants up to here. I'm not even joking. I call them granny pants.
Mel?
You forgot, didn't you, love? Not to worry.
Slippers, very good. Hospital floor, not so good. It's what makes you feel comfortable, OK? So it is your choice. And if you forget something, don't worry, because you can always fetch it later.
I didn't want to think about this ever again, frankly, but a friend convinced me.
I'm sorry, I don't quite see how...
Well, just a couple of days there, just to try and understand what makes made my biological father tick.
You do know that the house isn't as he left it. Most of his things have gone.
Oh, I'm not interested in his stuff.
No, I wasn't suggesting...
Just getting a handle on who he was, that's all.
Yes. Yes, I see. Sorry,
No, I shouldn't have asked.
No, of course you should. And, well, look, if it makes you feel closer to him, then absolutely you should go to the house. tell you what, why don't I come with you? I could show
you. Honestly, I'd really rather do this on my own.
Of course.
I'm ever so sorry. Dr. Veer's running late.
Apologies.
You do know you've got two others waiting.
Yeah, I know. Please, do come through.
Any sign of Mrs. Hall?
Afraid not.
Oh, my second no-show today.
You can have some more seats.
If people knew the cost to the NHS of missed appointments.
I know, we should put signs on.
A complete waste of a GP's time.
Yeah, when there are people who are desperate to be seen.
You're absolutely right. Please tell Mrs. Tembe that I really must pop out after all. Thank you, Karen. And thank you, Dr. Carter.
Don't mention it.
Encourage your partner, any of the siblings the baby might have, a family member to have a go. Changing nappies is a time to talk and sing to the baby. It's a bonding opportunity. OK? Well, let's go for it.
Lovely.
And do remember, a real baby is a lot messier.
Is that right, Lila?
Total control here.
How do you think they're coping?
I think Mel's going to make a very instinctive mum, don't you? Something wrong, Beth?
This care plan.
Yeah.
What happens if they miss more appointments?
Oh, I don't think it's going to come to that. Look how hard they're working together.
Yes, but you won't always be around, will you, to bail them out?
Bail them out?
Well, you know, pick them up, drive them places.
Oh, I see. No, this morning, that was unusual.
Yes, but it will have been recorded, won't it? They're missing stuff.
Yes, it would.
Well, all I'm saying is, what happens if social services get twitchy?
Look, it's true, they'd investigate any concerns, and but missed appointments could be a trigger. However,
look, Mel puts on a brave face, but underneath it all, she is not that confident, and with a memory problem, she struggles. Now, I don't want to see her fall apart if...
If what?
If they don't let her keep it.
I think that we should talk about this later. Look, what you're saying, there is support in place, and I really don't think it is going to come to that.
Cheers.
We're talking about social services.
What?
Might take the baby.
Receptionist myself, actually, as it happens. Oh, I know all about doctors running late. So perhaps if I just come back at another time.
Miss Pittman.
Valerie.
Dr. Hammer, sorry to keep you waiting.
You're clearly very busy, Doctor. And I'm really not worth bothering about.
Oh, why don't you let me be the judge of that?
Well, I don't want to waste your valuable time.
What if my time's too valuable for my patients and I'm in the wrong job?
Remember, not all women's nipples are here. For some women, they're down here. We're all different, and that's what's great. I think it's really important that you have skin-to-skin contact, especially in those first few days. Can anybody remember why? Jason?
I forgot. Sorry.
It's OK. That's fine. It's that bonding that we were talking about. So, if you're having problems feeding the baby, try getting in the bath together. It's a great idea. Basically, wherever you are, whatever you want to do, make sure you are comfortable.
Yeah. Come on, Mel.
She doesn't want to.
OK, so remember, it is baby to breast, not breast to baby. Yeah? Do you see how the baby's mouth goes round the line of the nipple?
You've got to try.
It's up to Mel.
Mel?
OK, why don't we have a quick tea break and pick it up later?
Thank you. You all right?
You wanted to do breastfeeding, you said.
Yeah, but she can change her mind, can't she?
Yeah. It's always Mel's choice.
Can't do it right.
Do what right? Mel.
Can't do anything right!
Hey, come on. Don't get worked up. Let's get you a drink. Come on.
Oh, sorry.
Here we are. I'll talk to her.
Okay.
mountain out of a molehill. It'll be my personal problems. I don't talk about it much, all of our cross to bear, but ever since the breakup, I have barely been sleeping.
How long's sleep been an issue?
I really thought Ashley and I were soulmates. It's ridiculous, really, to get myself worked up into such a state. I mean, no one ever died of a broken heart.
Well, there's some poets that might dispute that. I'm sorry about Ashley, but the sleep problems, Valerie, how long exactly?
A few weeks, I suppose. It's probably nothing. Everyone knows what a fusspot I am.
And you mentioned swollen glands?
Yeah, it'll be a virus, but yeah. Thank you. Listening to all my nonsense.
Valerie.
No, I feel much better, actually, having talked it over. Now, I should let you see some really sick people.
Do the doctors at the mill let the patients self-diagnose?
Sorry?
They let the patients tell them what's wrong with them?
Oh, no. No, that would not go down well with some of our GPs. Especially Dr. Haskey. He blames the internet.
Well, I must admit, I do like to examine my patients too. May I? Right, that's it. Now, those glands of yours.
Safeguarding is in my mind too, of course. Two missed appointments. No, I am not downplaying it. Look, the point is they are here now with me. What? When? This morning? No. Yeah, no, I see. Look, Sarah, I'm sorry. No, I'll catch you later. Yeah, bye.
They're at the machine.
Bev, what you said earlier.
Look, I gotta calm down. This all got too much.
What did?
Well, this, you know, she sees all those other mothers. She knows they're not... Well, you know, she worries what kind of a father Jason's going to make. You know, what happens if there's something wrong with it? I mean, how is she going to cope?
All new parents, they have the same worries.
Yeah, but most parents can read the instructions on a medicine bottle and they can remember when the last feed was.
Bev, why did you ring the family support worker today?
Why are you asking?
She said that you raised concerns about Mel and Jason, about their parenting.
Well, I'm a mum. I'm allowed.
Yeah, of course. Look, I'm just wondering, how are you feeling about this baby?
I don't know what you're getting at.
I can't find Mel anywhere.
You... Oh. Okay.
Any pain in this area?
No. No, it's nothing like that. It's not pain, exactly.
Mm-hmm. What does it feel like?
Sort of achy.
Okay. I'm just gonna check around your armpits now. Okay. Is it achy here too?
Sure, we're well over our 10 minutes.
Just keep those doctors in line at the mill.
Well, some are more thorough than others.
Well, no harm in being thorough, I say.
So, doctor. How long have I got?
Well, there is some swelling. And taking your other symptoms into account, there could be a number of possible causes. So I'd like you to have some blood tests with our nurse.
Tests? What for?
Well, it could be a straightforward infection, so we can get those done right now.
Today?
Today. And I'd also like to refer you to a haematologist at St. Phil's.
What? Well, why do I need to go to St. Phil's? What will they do?
Well, that could involve a CT scan, and they may also take a biopsy.
A biopsy?
That's right.
But a biopsy, that means it could be...
Well, I'd prefer to explore all options at this stage.
Anything?
No, I'll check outside.
Will they take the baby away?
Why are you saying that, Jason?
You said about social services.
Oh, no, Jason, no, nobody wants that.
I tried to sort out the calendar, she wouldn't let me.
Who wouldn't let you?
Bev.
Bev sorts the calendar?
Takes the hospital letters too, in case we lose them.
But you kept that one?
She forgot it.
Right, come on, down here.
The nurse can squeeze you in, Valerie.
Thank you.
And you'll be seen at St. Phil's within a fortnight, so we'll speed you through, save you more of those sleepless nights.
I nearly didn't come today.
We know that every possibility is being examined now.
Yes, and one possibility is that...
Well, we can't be sure of anything until the test results come back, OK? Well, Maggie will look after you, so try not to worry. Take care now, Valerie.
Come this way.
Thank you.
fucking all over for you.
I just can't. I can't.
Mel.
Oh. I can't. I just can't.
You're still my baby, aren't you, eh? It's all right. It's all right.
Come on.
Please, just nice.
It's all under control, Mrs. Denby.
What have you done to the printer?
No, 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 nothing. It's just a slight technical hitch, look.
A slack! I want this all cleared up.
Sorry.
Sid, just try and slow down a bit.
I've got so much to do for tomorrow.
Well, maybe ask for some help.
Ask who? You didn't want to do the banner. Survey's gone down like a cup of cold sick. No one wants to do the Guardian pledge. Al thinks we're all just going to die anyway, and now Mrs. Denby hates me for breaking the printer. I've not even started on the display yet. I haven't even had a cup of tea yet, and I'm so far behind with
Mrs. Pembroke's here.
Patience. No one's interested. No one thinks this campaign's important.
Apart from that?
It's all hunky-dory. Mrs. Pembroke, would you like to follow me through?
Where are they going?
There!
Hey!
I'm taking her back. She's having
a... Come back to class, Mel. They won't take away the baby. If we try, rumour says.
Who are you? Making promises you can't keep.
I'm not. But I see a couple desperate to make it work.
Do-gooders, full of hot air. Who's picking up the pieces when it all goes wrong?
Look, I know that you're scared.
Care plan this, support that. What support? Ticking boxes so they can say they tried before they take the baby. Anyway, who's going to watch her break her heart when it all goes wrong?
Is that why you rang social services? Or you changed the calendar?
What?
Look, I know you were trying to protect her, but and you're taking the decision away from her, but it's not working.
You changed the calendar!
It wasn't our fault, Mel!
Get back in the car! Get back!
Viv.
Yes, yes, of course. Right, goodbye. Ah, Miss Pittman, I was not expecting you to be so long.
Sorry, Mrs. Tembe.
Well, these all need to be input into the database as soon as possible.
Of course.
Oh, Valerie. Mr. Isaac's bullets need to go off urgently.
Right. Thanks. Mill Health Centre.
So you forgot?
What did you forget?
The slippers, the nighty and the granny pants.
Don't get all stirred up again. She's got no right to judge us.
Yeah, but you remembered the baby stuff, didn't you?
It's ruined.
It's a bit dusty.
So, do all those stars. The night before Mel arrived, I felt the contractions coming and fading and...
And Nan said to take the man off the way.
Finished the last one just before my waters broke. You kept it.
For my baby.
I'll give it a wash. It'll come up fine.
Mum, I can.
Oh, let me sort it.
Please, Mum, I can. We can look after our baby.
She brought the song too. Check this out. You held me down because I got up. First song for the baby, this one. Deserved one at that. I've got the eye of the tiger fighter.
Bev, they stand a better chance with you behind them.
And you're gonna hear me roar.
The magic ASCII touch.
Want to turn it on and off again?
Look, hang on a minute. Sid is speechless. Quick, somebody take a photo.
See, we do give them monkeys.
Yeah, just not when it's rammed down our throats.
We're all behind you, mate.
Aren't we?
Oh, yes, Dr. Veer. I am very proud to be an antibiotic guardian.
I'm an antibiotic guardian.
I'm an antibiotic guardian.
I'm an antibiotic guardian.
I'm Spartacus.
Ow.
I'm an antibiotic guardian.
Thanks, Aisha. And you guys, thanks, everyone.
Oh, I'm glad everyone rallied round Sid in the end.
Yes.
Oh, what did your doctor say?
Fuss about nothing as usual.
Do you really not know who I am?
I don't care who you are.
I know you, Chloe Grant.
What? What are you doing?
Well, someone's got to hand out these leaflets.
Answer the questions. That's all. But don't give them anything more than they need to know.
Okay. Look, I've got a patient, but give me 10 minutes.
No, I don't want to talk to you.
Oh, you're trying to make me feel bad about how I told you that happened years ago! You don't know what bullying is.
A Body on the Beach next on BBC One.